Life is lived and life ends, but life continues through eternity, through our hope in the resurrection from the dead. November the 1st is All Saints Sunday, or All Saints Day, and November the 2nd, All Souls Day. In many parts of our world, this feast is either celebrated on the day or it is moved to the Sunday. That's why we have All Saints Sunday today. We remember those we love, but see no longer. We remember those who were before us, that great company of saints. They lived, they died, and yet they live. Since we last met, for this kind of service on All Saints Sunday, we have all either lost a loved one or know someone who has lost a loved one. Even as we sit here this morning, some of us have friends who have lost loved ones who are yet to be buried. Or possibly during the past week we were with a friend or a family celebrating the life of their loved one. Loss is never easy. Loss is usually greeted with pain and sadness. And sometimes we are so overwhelmed by such grief and loss and pain that we lose ourselves. Sleep less, eat less, wonder whether we would actually make it. A loss is a loss. The loss of a lover due to a broken relationship breaks the heart of the one or both of them as they deal with life without the other. The only consolation, they might move on. Each party can be happily married and they can still remain friends. Loss of job. One of the problems about our world today is that we don't want to take time to grieve when we lose something. I have several friends. They lose their job today, tomorrow they are on the web now because internet has made it easy. They are searching for a job. They don't grieve. And sometimes that is shifted into the everydayness of our lives, not to take time to mourn the losses of our lives. That's why we live more in a depressed world rather than a world that has the capability of handling these tensions of losses. Imagine someone who has been seeing for all their life and now losing their sight. It's a loss. It's painful. Or possibly the ability to walk on their own. Now they have to carry support system to go from place to place and somebody has to go with them. It's a loss. Their mobility, the restriction. Or when it comes to that time when possibly the government or the children says, "Mommy, Daddy, you can drive no longer." A loss of one's freedom of going to wherever one wants to go to. Loss, my friends, is never easy. And when we lose a loved one, pain, sorrow, grief, sadness continue sometimes for a very long time. Sometimes we ask the question, will I ever make it? And if you ask that question, the reality is that yes, you made it, tough as it was. The gravity of the pain may be minimized not because of the connectivity we have with the one that is lost, but possibly through the support system of others who come around us. and enable us to march through life in support system. And I believe that's one of the functions of why the church is such a vital part in our lives, supporting one another when we have lost a loved one. One of the familiar passages was read a few minutes ago from Matthew chapter 5. It's called the Beatitudes, or the Beatitude of those who are in Christ. What is expected? How do we live our lives? How can we live this life? How can we live this life in hope? To live this life in hope, we need to recognize that not everything will be nice every day. There will be difficult times. What I find interesting about this passage is that this passage is read during All Saints. It's read at weddings, and it's read at funerals. And I wondered why, and I keep wondering. Every verse from this scripture presents a paradox. How can one who is poor be happy? How can one who has lost a loved one find a sense of happiness, because blessed is the same word as happy? How can someone who is being persecuted be happy? Possibly, the shift occurs in terms of our own relationship with God. Greeted with a feeling of pain or sorrow, but there is this promised mystery. The mystery that came to us in the incarnate Son of God. When God became a human being, God brought hope. So we can live this life with a feeling of hope that yes, we live, we die, but life continues beyond the grave. Our individual experience with death make us ask many questions. Sometimes the questions are, why me? Or why not me? I was in a situation in which one of the spouses died. And the other one who was alive said, why not me? In tears and in brokenness, I said, you know, possibly God knew that you will stand the test better than the other one. Other questions were about, what about? What about this and what about that? I'm sure you would agree with me. One dies, but life goes on. And what abouts take care of themselves? You don't believe me? Go to some of the places where men held distinctive positions of leadership and they died. The business did not close down. It continued. Or who is going to do this or do that? Irrespective of what we occupy ourselves with, death is a reality. And our lives are testimonies of those who live after us as an emblem of our faith. Those who may never know us, and those we may never know. In the annals of God, their names are written because of a relationship that was established between them and the Lord Jesus. Christ makes the difference. The Bible says, because Jesus rose again, everyone who is in Christ shall rise. So that's our hope. The hope of resurrection to eternal life, to be with God forever. We live, we die, we continue to live. What a mystery. This is the transforming aspect of in our sorrows, rejoicing in our emptiness, our spiritual emptiness. We are beckoned by God to be happy, relying in this comforting presence of God and His Spirit to carry us through. All of us have lost loved ones. I can say having, in this past year, I have lost many friends. Three of whom are my golf buddies. One is still to be buried and is in the funeral home. And I look around and I think to myself and I come to the conclusion that love is stronger than death. Amen. Because love enables us to go through the pains and tragedy of life. When death occurs, we need God's love to embrace us, to enfold us, and each other to sustain and to support each one of us. God's love for us is not ended when we die. Praise God for that. God's love for us is not terminated by physical death. What occurs when we do not know Jesus is the sad part of death. Death gives opportunity into the life beyond. One of my friends lost his mom. And while she was crying, he's an adult, while she was crying, his other friend met him and said, "Congratulations." He felt insulted. "Congratulate one. My mom died." And the guy looked at him. He says, "Now mom is seated with Jesus. And death cannot defeat her." My friend said it was like a cool, soothing spirit that overwhelmed him to realize that his mom has departed from life to eternity, from things that are temporal to things that are eternal. And she said, I was so confident of this because my mom knew Jesus. And because my mother knew Jesus, I know she is safe in the arms of Jesus. So living as Christians, we live in hope. Yes, we will die. I will. All of us will. And right now in the parish, we are dealing with the death. Yes, that's the reality of life. Our life will continue with Jesus. Because during our time of living, we received Jesus into our hearts and received a spiritual birth that brought us into the place where Jesus says, "Anyone who believes in me will not perish, but will have everlasting life." This spiritual birth confirms and gives us the sense of that even though we mourn now, we are happy because there is a glorious life awaiting where there is no more sickness, no more pain, no more death, no more sorrow, but we shall all be in the presence of Jesus. Jesus was raised from the dead. He dies no more. Death has dominion no more over him. The death that he died unto sin once, and the life that he lives unto God. Yes, we all will die. Death will hurt us. But the encouraging thing is death is followed by burial. And burial, the grave is not the end. We shall rise. We shall rise and we shall behold him face to face. When all of us will be gathered, our departed ones will be gathered with God. We will see them in the great multitude of all the saints among the nations and tribes, peoples and kindreds, languages, robed and dressed with sign of victory. We believe and we hope that hunger and thirst are no more. There is no scorching heat. They walk along springs of living water. God wipes the tears from their eyes. They look up the throne and are radiant. And yet, what we will be has not yet been revealed. But we know that when Christ shall come, we shall be like him. For we shall all be changed within a twinkling of an eye. We pray in signs and metaphors and paradoxes, but our hope is in the name of the risen Christ, and our hope is secure. And even in the transitions of our lives, we know that what we experience here, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, neither has it entered the heart of man, the unsearchable things that God has for those who are in Christ Jesus. We shall behold him face to face. This morning, I'm going to give each of us an opportunity to light a candle whilst I play this music. If you want to come, and as you light the candle, you just call the names. There are many unknown to us who are God's saints who are now at peace. As I light this candle of my three great friends who died recently, my golf buddies, I remember them. Every time I hit a golf ball, I remember them. And I thank God for their life and witness. Do you want to come this morning and light a candle? And if you want to name the names of those you light the candle for me this was Seal, Blanchard, and Christian, and the many host of those I cannot name this morning with you that I hold dear in my heart as fellow workers and laborers of Christ, and people who believed in the Lord Jesus. You want to come pick up the candle this morning? As you light, you call the name of the one for whom you light the candle. And we're going to be lighting the candle, and for those who are able, who will stand right here, then we will say a prayer in thanksgiving for the lives of those we remember this morning. Come on. While I play this music, and as you come, to be very low so you can mention the name of the one you want to remember this morning. can prophesy for you. And now in our hearts we hold the memory of those who died in California through fire and other natural disaster. Remember the souls of those in New York this past week. Days are without end numbered. Make us, we beseech you, deeply sensitive for the shortness and uncertainty of life. And let your Holy Spirit lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days, that when we shall have served thee in our generation, we may be gathered into our fathers, having the testimony of a good conscience, the communion of the Catholic Church and the confidence of a certain faith and the comfort of a reasonable religious and holy hope, in favor with thee, our God, and in perfect charity with the world, all which we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the saints say, Amen.
Amen.